Hi, my name is Bill Will.
In this video, I'm going to show you how to turn this into this. All the bodies I've done, they're all basic with like 3-4 colors. I'm also going to show you how to recover from mistakes made. I want to keep the layout as basic and simple as possible, so I'm not like beating my brain up.
I've also listed below the material and the tools that I use that make doing these bodies a whole lot easier. Make sure you watch the whole video before attempting to do this. That way you know kind of what you're up against. I made a lot of mistakes when I first started doing this, and I covered it up with stickers. And at that point, the objective was to make the car look fast sitting still. If you got any leftover stickers, you can sticker up your toolbox. Make it look fast too.
Let's just get started. These are the tools you're going to need. You're going to need an Exacto knife. This is a hole punch like Reamer. I use Loctite. You're going to need your scissors. This is a razor blade, but it's like a compass for your wheel wells. And of course, your marker and your tape. For some reason, the video didn't turn out, so I'm going to use this body real quick to give you an example. So when I lay out my design, what I do is I get a piece of tape and do this. It's not as sticky. And say I want to put a line right there. Now I can get a straight edge. And that's how I draw out my lines. Then I go over here. Do it like that. Pretty simple. Now I got my lines, so when I go back to tape it, I can just put my tape in there. Trace my lines with tape.
This is what I come up with.
So let's say you make a mistake. So what you do is you get some rubbing alcohol or peroxide, and it'll strip the, you know, magic marker off. And you can go back and wipe it off. That way you don't accidentally tape that off and mess your whole paint job up. Just like that. And if you don't like your design and how it turns out, well, you can just go wipe it off and start over. Step two, you want to cut out the body, the wheel wells. This is what I use for the wheel wells. I line it up. So right there, it's in the crack. I spin it around. Make sure it's in the crack there. And make sure it's hitting right all the way around. And once it is, then I push in and make the hole in there so it's stable. And then that's it. And you just do this a million times, and that's that. You get your scissors. Notch it out just so my scissors don't bind, and I can go in with a nice, clean, straight cut. A little trimmy. Got the wheel wells cut out perfectly round. Also, what you want to do is keep these. I got all these right here. If you're doing candy paints or, you know, transparent paints, it's good to do a sample, and you want to get the right shade of color where you do a couple test samples. A little tip, always leave your tape standing up. And the reason being, if it falls over, it's going to collect all the trash, all the lint, dirt. And this roll's already kind of fell over. But for taping along the bottom of the body on the outside, it's perfect. I wouldn't use this roll of tape to tape off my lines because your lines will pick up all that trash. So when you peel your tape off after you painted it, you'll have all that debris in your paint. Now there's some contrast there. I can see where I'm cutting. I don't have to eyeball it. I'm not going to have all jaggedy, raggedy cuts. Be nice and clean. There you have it. Boom. It's a nice clean cut. Okay, for the front, I'm going to make a splitter. And how I'm going to do that, I'm probably going to cut all this off. Do a little curve right there. Same thing with this side over here. I got the splitter. I just used what was there. And every bend, make a slice. There's a slight curve right there in the middle. And then there's a curve there and a curve there. And then this part's straight. And that little piece is straight.
And then you bend them up.
That's how I did it on both sides. I think it turned out pretty good. You get the idea. That's how you make a splitter. You can do it on the sides if your body lines are straight, but this, it's got a bunch of, I don't know, the plastic mold. It wasn't the same length. It was kind of messed up. I just did the front. Other thing, too, you're going to be punching holes. Not everybody's got magnets. If you're going to punch holes, you're going to need one of these. You punch your holes. Yeah, do the holes for your wing. Step four, you want to get a little bit of soap. Put a drop in there. A little bit of water. I bought this sponge, especially this just RC car stuff. It's really soft. It's not gonna scratch the finish. There's a film inside these bodies, and if you paint over it, it'll cause the paint to flake off. It won't hold or stick. You just want to wipe it real good. Now it's just a matter of getting all the soap off of it. And I got a really soft rag that I bought from the auto parts store. It's like microfiber. I can dry this off. Give it, 10, 15 minutes and let it air dry. It'll be ready to tape. So that's the rag I was telling you about. It works good.
Next is the window mask.
So I've started the taping process. I'm taping off white first because white, it doesn't matter how much white you spray on this. What'll happen is if you go to spray one of these other colors, it's going to show through your white. So white is always the last color you do. Like a body like this, see how deep that crack is? Some of these lines. Like, if you don't get the tape pressed all the way up in there, when you go to spray, it's going to spray in there. And your whatever color you're spraying is going to get where the other color is supposed to spray. So what I do, I use the Loctite because it's real thin. So I get it on my line. You want to get the Loctite and push it down in there. That actually worked out pretty good. The way I taped it was I taped the white first, then I taped the red, and I didn't do the yellow. I'm going with three colors. I'll spray the yellow first, then I'll peel the top layer off, and then that'll expose the red, and then when I get done with the red, then I'll peel the white. It'll be done. I'm just basically going to do probably one or two coats of yellow. use your blow dryer in between coats. That way, if you do happen to bump it or touch it, it doesn't leave a mark or an imprint. I'm gonna do like a bowling ball type mineral kind of effect on this. I'm gonna use saran wrap and mirror chrome. I did use silver for a long time, but the chrome makes it pop a little bit more. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna spray this and lightly dab it. I don't want to smash it flat. I just want to lightly dab it so you get all this, you know, wrinkle effect. If you just smash it flat, that kind of takes away. You might as well just spray it solid. What I do is I just wrinkle it up. That's pretty much what it'll look like when I get done dabbing it. Now I'm gonna back it with black. Alright, now that I got the black paint covering it, it fills in all the gaps. What I did is I peeled off the tape. You can see now I'm going to paint the red. I went back and kind of just smashed all the white, especially in these cracks and corners. Like, this is a really hard body. Like, I don't think I've ever painted a body with this much curves. And now I'm going to paint it red. Got the red on there. I blow dried it. Got it all heated up, cooled off. I'm about to break out the chrome and saran wrap and start dabbing it. About to hit it with the black. Alright, next step, peel the tape off. I ran into an issue. The paint bled through right here where my finger is. I don't know if you can see that. There's one right there. And then on the back, I guess the tape, I didn't have it all the way up to the edge, so there's overspray all in this area. And how you fix that, you get you some dot three, and you want to get very little on your Q-tip because you don't want it to hit the other paint, because then it'll take it off too and mess it up. You don't want to saturate it. And it takes it right off. And you make sure you wipe that real good. Maybe use the other side, dry it off. Now that I got my overspray and that little bit off, now I'm gonna blast it with some white. What? Cut! Do a little bit of white in there. Do it light the first time. Get you a nice little thin coat. The paint job's done. But I noticed there's a little bit of paint. What I use is pinstriping. I got all different colors. You can put the mask back on as a dust cover. Another tip, don't just rip it off. And that'll help preserve your paint job and keep, you know, fingerprints and grease and all that off of it. Here, let me show you this other car. This is what I'm talking about. You'll see that. And peel it off, and it's like brand new. Get the camera over here.
Before this next step, you might want to put on gloves or wash your hands a bunch of times.
Start peeling it off. Usually when you get it started, it works out pretty good. This mask is a little bit thinner. Look at that. That turned out nicer than I thought. And there's imperfections, but like I said, the pinstriping will hide that. I don't even know what step. I'm on step 5. I'll do my windows. I'll do those next. And I usually try to avoid the pinstriping going, you know, down in parts like this. I've done it before, but it's real time consuming. And then by the time you got all these curves and you go through all them curves, like, it's hard to get it straight, because when you're going straight and then it bends down, now you're pointing that way, and then you go down, then you're pointing over more, like, and it comes out all jagged. Try to avoid that and just keep all my pinstriping in, you know, away from my body lines. Keep it on nice flat areas. A couple spots ain't too bad here and there, but especially the back, good God. That's why I cut that off right there, because there's going to be a sticker that goes over this. And I cut it off there because, you know, it's going to cover that hard line between the color and the white. It'll just be a black, I guess, like a grill or whatever's in the back that goes there. So these are the stickers that came with it. Get your Exacto. And don't forget to wash your hands, because that's real important before you put these stickers on. As you're putting the sticker on, you want to smash it into the body line, because you don't want air and dust to get underneath it and then it peels up. You get the idea. I'm going to go ahead and finish out the windows, and then I'm going to head on to the pinstripe. Well, I got the stickers on there, and I was going to go with blue, but these colors pop too much for blue, so I went ahead and went with the gold. As you can see, it kind of cleaned up the body lines. But I noticed, I don't know if y'all can see it, but there's like a, I don't know if I had oil on my finger or what was going on. So what I'm going to do is cover it up with a sticker. Stickers hide a lot of your imperfections. Like, you never know, you can't help it, but dust might blow on the body and then you paint over it, and now you got this big mark. Booty. This is what I got so far. On the hood, I usually run everything at an angle, but everything else I pretty much run parallel with the pinstriping or the body lines. Like, especially on the side, I try to get it level. The dope mobile. Got a little spot to fix there. I'll put a sticker over that and you'll never see it. Right there at the bottom of the windshield. Try to keep all the stickers kind of spaced out, because you want to see the paint job. But at the same time, you want it to pop. Another thing about these stickers, some of them are pre-cut out. Like, but the problem is you see where the edge of the sticker is? It'll be cut way out here. You want to cut as close as you can, cut as best as you can. That's kind of what you end up with. It's popping pretty good. I still got that side to do, but I'm pretty much done with the hood, the top, the sides. There's the back. No back. I get a mirror and set it up, and that way I can do this side and try to line it up with that side. I don't have to keep touching the body and flipping it around and messing with it. And that's pretty much how you get both sides looking close. You know, it's not going to turn out exactly the same. Like, take that for example. The A's like that on that side. Then you go to the other side. The A's on the other side. On your driver's side, everything runs to the back of the car. On the passenger side, everything runs to the front of the car. You know, stickers like that would be good for both sides. Well, you get stickers like this, that little VP part sticking out on this side might line up good with the body, but on the other side, it's just sticking out there and it kind of throws all the other stickers off. All right, she's done. That's what we're looking at. When it comes to these stickers, I try to put as much as I can on the car. I try not to leave too many bare spots. Some places, you know, I put very few, but I space them out just right to where, you know, it kind of fills in. Don't leave any bald spots. All These are Knight Rider LED light kits. Built them from scratch. I get all the parts off of eBay. The camera really doesn't do it justice because they are extremely bright. That's the little power booster and then the wire. And it's all wired in and hot glued in. But yeah, that's my next video. And I'll put a listing of everything that you need and all the tools and stuff to build that kit. Also, thank you all for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share. It really helps out with the algorithm. I like to keep doing this and just trying new things and new colors and paint jobs and new builds. Thank you.